Hello, everybody. My name is Provis, and welcome to the new enhanced definitive edition for Age of Empires 3. Microsoft and their partners were kind enough to get me an early copy of this remaster so I could share my first impressions with you guys, and a big thank you to them for that. It really is appreciated. The game is releasing today, October 15th, so be sure to look for a link in the description if you're interested in learning more. Now, you all might be aware that Age of Empires 2 is one of my all-time favorite strategy games. It was an absolute masterpiece, and it still sits near and dear to my heart. So Age of Empires 3 has always been in a rather daunting position of trying to fill those shoes. You might expect the original developers to attempt to clone the earlier creation when this game was first released in 2005, but you would be wrong. Age of Empires 3, while sharing some core mechanics and themes, is ultimately a very different real-time strategy game. It doesn't really try to copy past successes, but rather tries to innovate for the next big hit, which I can certainly respect. I bring all this up because, at the end of the day, so long as AoE 3 lives in the shadow of its predecessor, it can't help but fall short by comparison, but if you can see AoE 3 as a standalone game, it stands a much better chance. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to talk a bit about Age of Empires 3 itself as a game, which mostly is still intact since its 2005 release, and then I'll talk a bit about the new edition and what's been changed. First off, let's talk about theme. While Age of Empires 2 mostly featured the High and Late Middle Ages, Age of Empires 3 hones in on the colonial expansion of European powers into the New World. Interaction with the natives is an important mechanic in this game, and your chosen home city back in Europe can supply you with key boosts to your economic or military power. Technology has progressed to pikes and muskets, with artillery playing a huge role in warfare. The world of Age of Empires 3 feels different because it is different. The world is changing, and you need to change with it if you don't want to be a relic of the past. It's a good theme overall, though gunpowder and cannons don't hold quite the same romantic appeal as longbows and trebuchets. This theme is reflected in the game's campaigns, starting with the story of the Knights of St. John hunting for the Fountain of Youth in the New World, and eventually ending in the American frontier. I'll be honest, the original campaign doesn't excite me that much. Part of the appeal in Age of Empires 2 was the historical basis for stories, right? I learned a lot about Barbarossa, Saladin, El Cid, and many more as a kid playing that game. So these fictional stories just don't hold up for me in comparison. Once you progress into the expansions, however, I think that improves a lot. The first expansion added new campaigns for Native American nations, while the second added the Asian kingdoms. Now these are more interesting to me because they are the nations being colonized or influenced rather than the colonizers themselves, and the mechanics change accordingly to reflect that. Alright, now let's talk a bit about the gameplay, and what I'm showing you here is a skirmish that I set up as a Swedish colony, which is actually a new nation added in Definitive Edition. Firstly, you may note that stone is no longer a resource, you just need to harvest food, wood, and gold. Second, workers no longer need to transport their goods back to the town center or a storehouse. If they are working the resource, it automatically gets added to the stockpile. This means building placement is not as crucial as before, and it's a bit easier to keep your economy efficient throughout the match. So the macro game is easier in Age of Empires 3. Third, military buildings can't even be built until you reach the Second Age, so super early rushes are no longer a thing, though the first player to reach that Second Age is going to have an innate advantage. All these changes will have a significant impact in your early game. Another thing to note is there are treasures spread throughout the map, which is new in AoE 3. Every nation gets at least one hero scouting unit that can plunder these treasures for extra resources or free units. Basically, there's more incentive to scout the map than just sniping your rival's sheep. You may also notice some special icons on the minimap for native tribes and trading posts. Using a settler or your hero, you can construct an outpost at either of these locations. The tribes can give you access to unique native units and technologies, some of which are pretty powerful, while the trading posts will eventually create a steady supply of free resources. So long as you can hold on to control of that outpost anyway. Other nations might fight you for it. In the very top left, you can see your nation's flag with a little number, which will go up every now and again. This represents favor, which you've earned from your home city, and you can spend these favor points on special cards. Depending on what you select, your home city might send you some more resources, free units, and unique racial technologies. You earn more favor by earning experience. How do you earn experience? Well, primarily through the training of units, constructing buildings, plundering treasures, trade posts, or killing enemy units. Basically, just by playing the game well. Progressing to the next age in-game will open up new card options, some of which are going to be very powerful, like a free fort or a factory. As for the military, you can compose your army of infantry, cavalry, or artillery units. Both infantry and cavalry usually offer at least one melee option and one ranged gunpowder option, though this may vary between nations. Artillery, on the other hand, have several different varieties. You can hire grenadier infantry for early building destruction, anti-infantry guns, anti-artillery guns, or the mighty howitzer to obliterate structures at a distance. And interestingly enough, you can train multiple units at the same time from each building in batches, allowing you to quickly fill up your population capacity. Personally, I love using lots of artillery in Age of Empires 3. They may be slow and vulnerable, but if you can get enough of them in your back line, you can completely shred enemy armies. The AI rarely seems to know how to respond, especially if you can keep some spare pikes available to guard your flank. And that's it. That's really all you need to know to get started. Just expand, exploit, and exterminate. So what does the Definitive Edition change? Quite a few things, actually, though mostly it's just icing on the cake rather than a complete rework. First, and most obvious, Definitive Edition completely overhauls the graphics. New models, animations, particle effects, lighting, and more bring the game into 4K. I don't have my old AoE 3 discs anymore, but there are a few images I can show you to show the differences in the models. It's pretty significant, and the game looks great now. We also get some new music for all of the nations, plus some UI quality of life changes. As an example, the UI now shows how many workers are currently assigned for each resource, making it a lot easier to keep track of your macro game. That's something that was added in the AoE 2 Definitive Edition as well, and I loved it. There are two new nations introduced in Definitive Edition, Sweden and the Incas, which is always nice. There aren't any new campaigns, sorta kinda. One of the first messages you'll receive when you log into AoE 3 is a notice that the Native American storyline introduced in the first expansion has been reworked a bit to remove some of the cultural inaccuracies and some, quote, problematic stereotyping. Apparently the devs have taken the extra effort to correct those and ensure that the native nations are more appropriately represented, which I think is a really nice touch. More cultural accuracy is always a good thing in historical games. As far as game modes, historical battles are a new option introduced in this edition, which I'm really excited about. This gameplay you've been seeing here actually portrays the 1516 Battle of Algiers, where the Barbary Corsairs secure their freedom from the Spanish with the help of the Ottoman Empire, changing the fate of the Mediterranean for decades to come. This is an awesome addition to the game. We also get the Art of War challenge modes, similar to what was added in Age of Empires 2, and these can help teach you the meta strategies for the game. And of course, multiplayer has seen a big update. Using the same server-based multiplayer matchmaking system introduced in the other Age of Empires remasters, which has been a very popular update, and I'm glad to see it here as well. Overall, the Definitive Edition is a definite improvement to Age of Empires 3. It's still not going to be my favorite installment in the Age of Empires franchise, for a few different reasons, and none of which have to do with this Definitive Edition remake, but more to do with problems I had with the base game itself when it first released, including changes to the macro, which I think make it a little bit too easy, and I'm also not as big of a fan of the theme and the storylines that were introduced. But I do still think it is a good game in its own right, and Tantalus Media and Forgotten Empires have done a very good job in faithfully restoring this game and bringing it into the modern gaming scene. It certainly does look beautiful, so kudos to them for that. Age of Empires 3 Definitive Edition is going to be available on Steam for $20 or included with your Xbox Game Pass for PC. I think that's a very competitive price point for what you're getting, so be sure to look at the link in the description if you'd like to pick it up for yourself. I do hope you found this video helpful and informative. If you did, then I would humbly ask that you hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe for my future content. My name is Provis, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.